My name is Sarah Longbottom and I'm the creative director of Rangatahi Toa. Rangatahi Toa creative arts initiative began 4 years ago in 2009 in Ōtara at Desire Dance Academy. What it looked like then is very different to what it looks like now and what you're experiencing in the gallery, but the kaupapa is exactly the same. It's always been about the kids and it's always been about the love. I guess that we are all here, all the adults who are involved are here solely and only for Tautoko kids through whatever they're experiencing now to be able to explore their own potential and to be the kids that we know that they are. They might not yet know it, but we know who they are and we see that. And in a week like this that we've just had, that absolutely comes to the fore.
With my mentor, I have been doing basically just my artwork, really, like my four boards and my one big board, and yeah, just been covering that up and planning it and stuff like that. My idea was family. Oh well, it was rappers, but I couldn't find any baby photos, so I decided to just do family and one or two fuck songs. I dedicate my artwork to my mum because, yeah, that song relates to her and me. C, yeah, she's cool. Fun, way fun. It's definitely not be boring. Interesting, I've learned a lot of things from her. She's just really cool. I like her. Just like new ways of doing things and new techniques and new designs. Like, she's suggested stuff that I wouldn't have thought of. But yeah, she's really helped me with it. It's pretty good.
We're just brainstorming some ideas for the boards, for her boards.
Yeah.
And we're just gonna come up with something when we get back.
Yeah. I'm really into art and this was just a big help to say that I actually did something artistic.
I've been doing a lot with my mental and it's been fun getting to know him and learning new things. Yeah, I've learned a lot ever since I came here. Even there's like 4 days. And I've improved a lot, developed my skills. So hopefully I can use those techniques that he's taught me and my artwork and that. So yeah. I used to just draw on my pad and just hearing everyone saying that I'm good, but I don't think I'm that good, but it's what everyone says.
My mental orders, started looking through my portfolio and you could see all those gospel things. So we both came up with the idea. And I was shocked that we were gonna do that biggie. So it'd be fun. Do your thing and just believe in yourself that you can do it. Don't give up. Yeah, that's my advice to you.
on me. Don't give up.
Well, we've been learning about, she's been teaching me stuff like different styles of art, like map making and blind contour and like collage stuff. That's pretty amazing. She teaches me, yeah. Well, my art piece is like, it's kind of like an installation. I'm gonna be having like a Tix poster, but it will be like an original of my writing. It's just more of like of what I've been going through and what I'm hoping to get out of all the stuff that I've learned, like with the other previous art exhibitions and this one. Like, you know, I'm hoping to teach it to my daughter. She grows up and, you know, even do some little art stuff for her room, make it look pretty. See, like the young bucks and stuff, you know, like, holy crap, was I like that? That is cool, like, you know, I've learned a lot.
First of all, my name is Tanfo Tanga, and I've been doing art for the last couple of days, and this man that's been helping me getting there. I haven't did art in a while, and he's a great man, and his name is Dan. This week, he has given me homework to bring information and design about my family. What they enjoy my design up on a paper to take our designs onto t-shirt. We are also doing our designs on the wall outside. This is all new stuff I haven't worked on before in life. Now this is good opportunity for me to take his advice for me to go on in life. My artwork is about my family and about my culture and what I love doing. And just for like the people out there whose family is like falling apart, just do something with it. And to the people that doesn't understand their culture properly, just fight for it and understand more about it. And if you love something, keep on going for it, keep on fighting, and never stop.
I ask for all my ancestors to come and help me do good lines, because this is difficult. So whenever you do Samoan patterns, paint with all of your fucking Samoan ancestors with you, and the shit will look good. That's fun.
Oh, Dan. Dan is a helpful guy. I give him a lot of credit to him, and it's been a great experience working with him. If it wasn't him, I wouldn't know how to draw or knew any stuff was breaking. Dan is like a helpful person. He's funny and intelligent, and he's famous for what he does. And he's shown me heaps of stuff. From this experience, I never learned anything until I came here, and I learned heaps of new stuff, like techniques with spray cans and how to color and how to draw and learn from Daniel, taking Daniel's advice. He's a good man and good artist, and I want to take my talent to the next level because of what he showed me.
This week we have been making a sculpture from planning drawings. There's a hidden message for the audience to discover. It's based on a poem. It's my artwork's about life, about kids who haven't been raised in a good environment, but they achieve their dreams in the end. They do it by themselves. This is represented in my sculpture. It's been good working with Chris. It's been a lot of help to me. Very helpful. without him, I wouldn't have made it this far. Chris has brought my creativity and helped me express my ideas for myself. I've learned creativity and a lot of stuff about art. I've learned about sculpture and how art can be different things. I've also learned aerosol skills. It's made me express my ideas, not hide them. I have got involved in heaps of stuff and can be creative in different ways. Wanna get back to school, be a normal kid again. Wanna be able to take advantage of the opportunities again.
My name is Kahurangi. I'm 15 and I come from Mangere. Her name is Shana, and it's been solid working with her. I've learned heaps of skills, and weaving, and I'm really grateful that she took the time to teach me how to do all that. How to weave like in the old times, on the panel. I don't know much about its history, but I just know that in the olden times, they did it like how we were doing it, on the panel and pushing the flex through the wood. And yeah, it's just based on my favourite colours, really. Red, yellow and green. I like those colours, so yeah. Just put my favourite colours on it. I've learnt how to weave a panel like in the olden times and do something I never thought I'd do. And yeah, I'm happy with what I've done. It's like an introduction into art, Māori art mainly. And it's opened another door of opportunity for me.
Well, we started just planning it out, doing like a bombing just in our black book, then we started on the wall, sketched it out on Tuesday. Yesterday we got some cans and that, went to the art gallery and sussed out what we're gonna do, what colours we need. Then we filled our sketching in, done our outline, done our aura and everything. And finished off our bombing. And this morning we done our dedication and that. And we're starting on our like a big page with different types of our sizes and stuff of our bombing. So we're gonna like mix it up and do like something like me, just out of it, to show what we can do, and yeah, hopefully we can suss that out today or tomorrow or something. Well, my artwork has my tag in it. It says Epic, and in the background it has a little city. And like a street pair sign that says Otara, no exit. And what that means is once an Otarian, always an Otarian. So like once you're there forever. It's your home. Yeah. Can control.
techniques, different styles and color combinations. I learned a lot, like about pages and sizes and what to use, what kind of ink, acrylic and enamel and stuff. And went to the art gallery, learned a lot there. Mm-hmm. And learned about different styles and oil paint and stuff like that.
You feel like that, you know that it's always going to be directly in front of you. You dig? So always keep the middle of your body, the middle of your face, the middle of your chest. Have your painting down here and go like that, you're losing paint. So you bend your knees, you feel like a dick, hard out. You hard out, feel like a dick, you have to put your body in all these stupid positions. But as long as you're in front of the paint, like that, it will always come off smooth and you won't waste paint. Because there's nothing worse than running out of a colour in the middle of the piece.
A lot of discipline. And it helps out. I didn't think it would help much. Knowing it's art, I thought it would have been quite boring, but it's a good experience. Helps to shape my future. Like good. Or I want to become like famous heavyweight champion or something and get up there with my graffiti and stuff, with different types of art. Probably would like to go to art school and stuff. Learn more about different types of art, photography and stuff. Get into acting and stuff, whatever.
My name's Judici, live in Meadowbank on the east side. Doing like stencil art on the computer. Tupac and Biggie, yeah. I've been using Photoshop and Illustrator, just learning how to use them properly. I'm gonna, get all the stencil and then what we done was scan it and put it onto the computer. Musical icons like, Tupac Shakur, Biggie and Jimi Hendrix. Yeah. It's been pretty good. Just sussing out how to use all the, like, Photoshop and Illustrator properly, learning how to use like digital, or maybe like next time I want to do some stencils, got a new way to do it instead of freehanding it. Can do it on the computer.
Yeah, this beautiful morning, have given us, bless everyone that's here, it's not here, bless our mentor and bless Sarah for bringing us together and having this thing. Bless our families and guide us throughout this day and guide the one that's not here. And in the name of Jesus Christ, amen. This week I've been drawing chopper designs and using spray cans to get the designs onto the wall. The designs are featured and some are from my sisters. My artwork is about my culture and it's a mix between Fijian, Maori and Samoan culture. These are the cultures of the people who have been collaborating on our wall. Working with Daryl has been mean. It's the first time for me doing up with spray cans. Told me heaps. He's cool and honest. He makes me feel valued. I've learned when doing type of designs, especially from your culture, to put all your heart into it. I didn't really think about my future much, but listening to Daryl is making me think about things.
Aukilangi I Nisila. Ya olone ile Africa. What's the name of this building, Miss?
Art station.
Yo lady, you want to like my art station? Ole aso lua ya la present and mako mea ona I mato faya ona la la o mai. Ya matamaiti na la fia matamata in nene. Ya olo ino ato fotang of tai lava ya manuile aso.
Oh, ladies. Oh, you just shout to any hanger? No. to my family, and hopefully I'll be famous one day, so you're asking for my signature. No. Yeah.
Oh, can I see shout out? Oh, shout out to my family in South Auckland and GI, East Side. Yep, and shout out to all the kids. Be strong and come to watch our exhibition. Watch my hour.
I must say a big thank you to everyone here. And what is this place called? Rangatahi? What is it? Yeah, everyone from the art station for helping me, believing in me, yeah. And having a lot of fun. Cheer.